Hello everyone. Today I am giving the lecture on biodiversity. Myself, Dr. Harish Kumar K from Government First Try College, Hoskota. The term biodiversity is very important term. When you think about the ecological balance, this biodiversity takes place a major important role. This was derived by the Walter G. Rosen in 1965. He says the biodiversity is derived by the Latin word bio means life, diversity means variety. The various scientists have defined biodiversity into different types. Firstly, when you think about the biodiversity definition, the number of variety of plants, animals and other organisms that exist in an ecosystem is known as biodiversity. That means variety and variability among the particular kind of a species. I repeat once again, variety and variability among the particular kind of a species is called as biodiversity. It is a measure of variety of organisms present in a different ecosystem. So, in the last previous class, I was told regarding the ecosystem. When you think about the forest ecosystem, when you think about the grassland ecosystem, examples I am giving, there in your life, these words, the variety becomes, that variety analyzing the measure of organisms is called as biodiversity. The rich states of biodiversity depends on the climatic conditions on the area of the region. Very, very important. When you think about North Pole region and the South Pole region, there the biodiversity will be less because there is a certain cold conditions. It will be the temperature will be minus degree Celsius. The mainly the living organisms depend on the temperature and the climatic zones. The third point says the richness of the biodiversity. When you think about the Western Ghats from the Gujarat, Tapti Nadi to Sri Lanka, where we can find a plenty of biodiversity. The temperature will be a normal. The scarcity of the biodiversity will be very rich. This richness of the biodiversity depends on the climatic conditions and the area of the region. Biodiversity is the result of 3.5 billion years of evolution. When you think about the evolution, last 3.5 billion years ago, this biodiversity exists. There are main three types of biodiversity. First one is called a genetic diversity, second one is called a species diversity, third one is called an ecosystem diversity. The term genetic diversity can be defined as variations in the genes of the certain species is called as genetic diversity. In Kannada we say manga ondu prabheda adre mangadalli vibhinna kaanisuvudu genetic diversity inda. Means a monkey is a kind of a species. The variations in the monkeys is called as a genetic diversity. Dog is one kind of a species. Variations in the dog is called as a genetic diversity. Mangifera indica is one kind of a species. Variations in the mangoes or Mangifera indica is caused from the genetic diversity. Even the twins in the human beings, which will be in the same look, same appearance, there will be a variations. That variations will be made from the genetic diversity. This genetic diversity is very rich. It should be there in nature. If you require the nomenclature, if you require the identification, this genetic diversity is the very, very important factors. Species diversity means variations in the species. Example, tiger is one kind of a species. Lion is one kind of a species. Variations in the species is called as a species diversity. That is also very, very important. The ecosystem diversity, variations in the ecosystem. When you think about the geographical area of India, example, I am talking about the India. There is a variation from the 10 kilometers. If you prolong, if you carry in the roadways, there will be a variation for every 15 to 10 to 15 kilometers. That variation in the ecosystem is called as a ecosystem diversity. These three types of diversity are very, very important. Next, when we go for the values of biodiversity, the values of biodiversity can be classified majorly into 4 to 5 types. One is called as quantitative value, economical value, aesthetic value, social values. I will show this one. Before going to the values of biodiversity, we shall talk regarding the biodiversity hotspots. A biodiversity hotspot is a region which is high level of endemic species that has experienced a great habitat loss. The hotspot means, this is the term which is derived by the IUCN, International Union for Conservation of Natural Resources. They have maintained one book called as a Red Data Book. They mention the various hotspots towards the globe. According to 2000 census, there is a 25 hotspots in the globe and 2 hotspots which will be located in India. One is called as Eastern Himalayas, another one is called as the Western Ghat Belt. These 2 hotspots are very, very important. In the next class, the further I classify the different hotspots and the laws of biodiversity. Thank you. Thanks, everyone.